Experimental probability is defined as the relative frequency of an event of interest, or the number of times that particular event occurred divided by the total number of times the experiment was repeated. Experimental probability needs an experiment to be done first, and then you can calculate the relative frequency of the outcome you're interested in. But if you repeat your experiment a large enough number of times, something very interesting happens to the experimental probability. Suppose I roll a normal six-sided die. There are six possible outcomes, numbered 1 through to 6. I might do the experiment 10 times, 10 rolls, and get a distribution like this. The graph shows the relative frequency of each outcome as my experiment progresses. But suppose I repeat the experiment a whole lot more times. After 50 rolls, the results look like this. After 200 rolls, like this. And after 1,000 rolls, notice how the relative frequency of all the possible outcomes has become basically the same. If I repeat the experiment often enough, the experimental probability of any one outcome becomes closer and closer to a particular fixed number. We call that number the theoretical probability. The theoretical probability of an event is simply a prediction in advance of the expected relative frequency of that particular event, if the experiment is repeated a large number of times. And the most remarkable thing is that for many simple experiments, you can predict very well and very simply the precise value of that probability. If you know the sample space, the set of all possible outcomes, and the outcomes are all equally likely, then the theoretical probability is just the number of favourable outcomes divided by the total size of the sample space. The predicted relative frequency is the number of outcomes that match your particular event divided by the total number of possible outcomes in the sample space. So, for that die rolling experiment, the theoretical probability of rolling, say, a 3 should be the number of 3s on the die, which is 1, out of the total number of possible outcomes, which is 6. 1 in 6. That's 0.16 recurring. Let's have another look at that graph. Yes, that's about the value that all the experimental probabilities are getting closer and closer to. Good. What if, instead, I'm interested in more than one outcome? What's the theoretical probability of rolling a number less than 3? Well, there are 2 outcomes less than 3 out of the 6 possible outcomes. So the theoretical probability is 1 in 3, or 33 1/3%. Now you could roll a real die many times and not get a number less than 3. You could get an experimental probability less or greater than 1/3. But if you roll the die enough times, your experimental probability, the relative frequency of rolling a number less than 3, will gradually get closer and closer to this value. Experimental probability is based on the actual outcomes after doing an experiment. Theoretical probability is based on the sample space alone. It's a prediction of what you expect to happen if you do the experiment a sufficiently large number of times. Sometimes you have to be careful about the way you count the sample space. Suppose I have a bag with some coloured marbles in it. Let's say there are 3 red marbles and 5 blue marbles. I'm thinking of performing an experiment where I take one marble out of the bag at a time. I'll put the marble I get out back in again before taking the next. What's the theoretical probability of drawing out a red marble? Well, what are the possible outcomes? What does the sample space look like? It's tempting to say the outcomes are red or blue, 2 possible outcomes. But actually, that's not enough. Remember, there are 3 possible red marbles and 5 possible blue ones. That's a total of 8 possible outcomes in my sample space. Of those 8, 3 of them are red. So the theoretical probability of drawing a red marble is 3 out of 8, or 37.5%. And of course, you can use theoretical probability to predict the expected frequency of an event in exactly the same way as with experimental probability. The expected frequency is the probability multiplied by the number of trials. Take our bag of marbles again. If I were to draw out a marble at random 46 times, how many red marbles will I get? Remember, we decided that the theoretical probability of getting a red marble was 3 out of 8. So the number of red marbles I should expect to get over 46 trials is just 3/8 of 46, which is around 17 times to the nearest whole number. I would expect to get a red marble out of the bag about 17 times out of 46.